father had a business, strictly second-hand. Everything from toothpicks to a baby grand. Stuff in our apartment came from father's store. Even things I'm wearing, someone wore before. It's no wonder that I feel abused. I never get a thing that ain't been used. I'm wearing second-hand hats, second-hand clothes. Oh, that's why they call me second-hand Rose. Even a piano in the parlor, Daddy bought for 10 cents on the dollar. Secondhand pearls I'm wearing, secondhand pearls. I never get a single thing that's new. Even Jake the plumber, he's the man I adore. He had the nerve to tell me he's been married before. Come on, everyone knows that I'm just a secondhand rose from Second Avenue. Oh my God, I love this song. I sing it every time I can. And once I even recorded it. It was in Milan some time ago. Wonderful, you know, big deal. But I never really understood English. Why the label only decided to put it out on cassette. Yeah, and you know, there were even recycled ones from some previous Nilla Pizzi recording, or, you know. But still, it can be really handy to be secondhand, because you don't have these huge expectations on you. You can take it easy and live lightheartedly. Everyone knows that I'm just secondhand Rose from Second Avenue. There is one song my father, my real father, Christina's father, used to always fantasize about when I was a kid. And it had this amazing title, Polvere di Stelle. My dad used to play it with his orchestras in the 40s and 50s in Italy. American standards were really popular. That's what you would hear when going out at night to dance halls and clubs. The Man I Love, Body and Soul, and this one song. For him, it was the quintessence of romance, and I hadn't realized that it's actually the song that I'm going to sing for you tonight, that Polvere di Stelle, it's the Italian translation for Stardust.
And now the purple dusk of twilight time steals across the meadows of my heart. High up in the sky, the little stars climb, always reminding me
that we're apart. You wandered down the lane and far away, leaving me a song that will not die. Love is now the stardust of yesterday, the music of the years gone by. Sometimes I wonder how I spent the lonely night dreaming of a song, that melody haunts my reverie, and I am once again with you. When our love was new, and each kiss an inspiration. Now my consolation is in the stardust of a song beside the garden walls when stars are bright. You are in my arms that nightingale tells his fairy tale of paradise where roses grew. Though I dream in vain, in my heart it will remain. My star melody, the memory of love's
So there is. What's going on, Steve? Okay. So. Yeah. Are you kidding?
No.
Okay. Yeah. I'm sorry. It's my husband. He's always checking on me. Wait, I'm giving a concert here. Oh, amore mio. Ciao, amore mio. Sì. No, mi fa piacere sentirti, certo, sempre. Sì, sto facendo il concerto, ma... Sì, no, va tutto bene, sì, 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 ti amo tanto. Rockport? Oh, it's very boring. No, there's nothing going on in Rockport. No, non ti preoccupare, ma figurati. No, there are no men in Rockport. No men at all. No, io amo solo te, tesoro mio, lo sai che penso solo a te tutto il tempo, non ti preoccupare, no. The pianist? No, non è bello, no, è bruttissimo,
no, no. Oh yeah, I mean he can play, yeah. Well, come on, of course, it's a great festival, yeah. No! Oh tesoro, ma davvero, ma non ti preoccupare. Lo sai che penso solo a te. Lo sai che tutto il mio amore per te, tutto il tempo. Non mi comporto male. Io tengo tutto il mio amore per te. Ma le sai queste cose? Do you need me to tell you during a concert? Oh, no, no, lo so che sei tu l'uomo che amo. No, non ne posso più di flirtare, sai, solo tu, penso solo a te tutto il tempo. No, non mi comporto male, tutto il mio amore è per te, tesoro. Davvero, credimi. Like Jack Horner in the corner, don't go nowhere, what do I care? Your kisses are worth waiting for. Oh, amore mio, te lo giuro, believe me. I don't stay out late, I don't care to go. I'm home about 8, it's just me and my radio. Ain't misbehaving, I'm saving my love for you. Oh, amore mio, ma lo sai com'è? It's a life like this, it takes you to places. Hello, well, there are men in Rockport. Hi, oh, yeah, I mean, it's far away, don't worry. Hi, there are women too. Hello. Hi. Okay. Don't want to embarrass you. Wow. It's a great place then. And misbehaving and misbehaving and misbehaving. I'm saving my love for you. Oh yes, Mr. Steve Pratzel. Italy in the 20s, you would have probably heard an American standard, or an aria by Puccini, or a folk song from Naples or from Puglia, for instance, because the great Italian song tradition started later, in the 30s and 40s, etc. But in the 20s, it was still the traditional songs from the different regions of Italy that people would sing. There is one song that I learned in Salento. It's a place at the very bottom of the heel of the boot, you know, where Italy is shaped like. And actually the subject is America. It's entitled L'America, because most people were leaving to come here and search for better lives. And sometimes these people would not go back. Sometimes husbands would find new wives. and make new families. And these women from Salento sometimes, not always, were left alone raising their children and feeling miserable and mad at America. So this is a little excerpt from a song that I would like to sing for you.
La meglio gioventù partiò all'America. La meglio gioventù partiò all'America. La meglio gioventù, Maria sorda mia, la meglio gioventù partì all'America. Marita che sciuta all'America e non mi scrive. Marita che sciuta all'America e non mi scrive. Sarà che sa ciò tua Maria sorda mia, sarà che sa ciò tu un'americana. Sì, tu sei la ciò dell'americana. Sì, tu sei la ciò dell'americana. Io mi giuccio a tua Maria sorda mia, io mi giuccio a tuo paesano. L'America non si chiama più l'America. L'America non si chiama più l'America. Si chiama la gioina, oh Maria sorda mia, si chiama la gioina della casa. Si chiama la gioina, oh Maria sorda mia, si chiama la gioina della casa. Si chiama la gioina, oh Maria sorda mia. Si chiama la gioina, della casa.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. everybody. Nice to see you. Thanks for coming back. This is great. You know, one of the, and I want to first do a great shout out to, I think, probably one of the greatest young quartets on the planet today. My goodness. The Vera String Quartet, everybody. Please give them a shout out. You know, there's something that might be of interest to you that, you know, we always think that the Ivy League is, you know, the heart, Harvard, you know, they're the hardest schools in the country to get in, to get accepted to. But there is one school that is absolutely the hardest, and that is the Curtis Institute of Music in Philadelphia. Now, so, okay, that's all right. I didn't go there, so you don't have to worry. But, so you think that that's, not only are these guys graduates of Curtis, but they are the first string quartet in residence at Curtis Institute. So they're the cream of the crop. Thanks for coming to this college. This is a special night. The opening of the festival has a very festive, gala-like atmosphere, and we're thrilled to be here. You know, with every great melodrama, silent melodrama, your participation is vital. Vital to the success of the movie. That means I want to hear you hoot and holler, yell, scream, boo, cry, all of that good stuff. We have our hero, of course, which is Buster Keaton. We have a villain. He goes to college, by the way, obviously. The villain is an athlete, okay? So the villain, but you know, at college, you tend to have those of us who are bookworms, nerds, and so on, you know, the academic type. And then you have the good-looking athlete, right? So you have one of each. I think, Pedro, you were the intellectual at college, right? And Justin, you were the tennis star, if I remember right. That's so the so one of each in Jeff, I'm staying with the Stonebergs. Jeff, what were you, a good-looking athlete or an intellectual?
Both.
Good for you. Okay. Well, anyway, so we have our villain, the jock. And so what are you going to do when you see the villain on the screen? That's it. We have a lovely heroine whose heart's torn between the jock and Buster Keaton. So, and she's really pretty and sweet and innocent, and she cries a lot. But what do you do when you see her? Her name's Mary. Oh, yes. And so if you get emotionally, you know, engaged with, you can cry too. So lots of sniffing. There you go. That's it. Yes. Yes, sir. And of course, our hero, Buster Keaton. What do we do when we see him? Okay, that's a little lukewarm. Let's pretend the Bruins won the Stanley Cup, okay? What do you do? Ah, that's it. Okay, well, you're in for a real treat. Here comes College starring Buster Keaton.
Oh. Thank you.